Hi, welcome back. Before watching this video, make sure you have also watched the first part. The links are provided below. Let's start with the front base frame assembly. The front side base frame is precision milled with the name of the manufacturer. We have to fix the Y-axis belt pulley with the frame. We can use two M4 6mm screws from the screws box to fix it. Let's attach the back frame of the base. First, let's attach the Y-axis end stop limit switch to the frame using two M3 nuts. Then attach a Y-axis belt pulley to a stepper motor and tighten the jack screw using an Allen key spanner. Then fix the motor to the back frame using two pieces of M4 6mm screws. Next, let's attach two stepper motors to the bottom base frame and then attach the shaft coupling to the stepper motor. But we will not tighten the jack screw now. It has to be tightened after the assembly. You need 8 M3 6mm screws to fix the two motors with the frame. These stepper motors are responsible for moving the hot end module on the Z-axis. Now attach the left and right base frame support with the bottom base frame using 4 M4 6mm screws. Let's attach the rear base frame to the support using 4 M4 6mm screws. Now we can attach the LCD module to the top frame using 4 M3 6mm screws. The LCD module also has the keypad to control the printer. Let's install this frame using 4 M4 6mm screws. The structure is almost ready. Now let's attach two Y-axis bracing pieces between the front and back base frames using 6 M4 6mm screws. This is going to be the platform over which the heatbed bracket moves. Let's prepare the heatbed bracket assembly. First, attach four linear bearings using four pairs of 3 M4 6mm screws to the heatbed bracket. Next, install the two M8 380mm Y-axis sliding rod through the linear bearings in the heatbed bracket and attach this setup between the front and rear base frames. You have to use the rods with holes on top and bottom. You may have to attach the front base frame at last. I mistakenly connected it already, so let's remove it and reattach it after installing the heatbed bracket. It looks like we are good. We can proceed to attach the Y-axis timing belt. Now insert the belt through Y-axis motor pulley and then through the front frame pulley and gently tighten the belt using two cable ties on the bracket. Now we can attach the heat belt. Use the four screws that came with the screws and nut box and attach it with four M3 4mm nuts and finally attach springs and hand nuts which are used to adjust the height of the heat belt on all four sides. Now let's install the Z end stop PCB using end stop metal frame. Then attach the end stop with the left side support frame using the two M3 6mm screws. It appears like I'm connecting incorrectly. Don't connect the way I did. The burr connector should face inwards with the frame as displayed on the screen. Let's install the left and right side LED screw fixer modules. First, attach the 3D printed LED screw fixer module to the top frame using two KA3 10mm screws and M4 6mm screws. Since this is a 3D printed part, you have to be very careful in inserting the screw, or else you may damage this part. Next, attach an X-axis stepper motor to the Z-axis left side slider and insert the 380mm LED screw rod which has a hole in the ends through the slider module. Now install the setup between the metal frame on the bottom left stepper motor and the top left fixer module and then tighten it using M4 6mm screws. Now insert the 380mm threaded LED screw that doesn't have holes at its ends. The threaded LED screw should go straight into the coupling at the bottom left motor. But don't tighten the jack screw on the coupling at this step. Now do the same for the right side Z-axis LED screw fixer module. When you insert the threaded rod into the coupling, make sure the coupling holds the rod correctly. Otherwise, move the coupling a little bit upwards and then lock the jack screw on the coupling. The motor shaft and the lead screw alignment through the coupling should be straight. Fine, now it's time to install the hot end module. First, make sure you align the left and right Z-axis slider and insert the slider rods through the right side slider module and then through the holes of the hot end and finally to the left side of the Z-axis slider module. It was difficult for me to insert the lead screw through the holes. Since the sliders are all 3D printed parts, you have to insert the rods very carefully. Otherwise, you might break the parts. It looks fine to me. Let's attach the timing belt just like we did for the Y-axis. Make sure the belt is tight before locking the tie. Alright. Now we can fix the inductive sensor. I'm not going to use the sensor right now, but still, let's keep it connected. The sensor can detect metals. If your base plate is not leveled properly, then the sensor can help the printer's computer program to compensate for the irregularities, thus giving quality prints. Next, let's assemble the filament feeder motor module. First, fix the pulley with the stepper motor and tighten it using the jack screw. Make sure one of the jack screw is facing the flat side of the motor shaft. Let's attach the feeder module to the motor using two M3 20mm screws. Place a HM5 10mm screw with a string attached to the feeder fitting. And then we need to connect a clamp mechanism to the stepper motor using a M3 10mm screw. You can adjust the 10mm M3 screw to adjust the pressure of the clamp. Let me check if I can feed the filament through this mechanism without any difficulty. Looks good. Let's attach the filament feeder motors to the top frame using 4 M3 10mm screws. It's time to install the controller board. First, insert the 4 M3 12mm poles to the left base frame using 4 M3 6mm screws and then fix the controller board using 4 M3 6mm screws. Now we can attach the power switch to the right side base frame. Here is something I don't like. The power switch is almost touching the metal frame. I am supplying 220 volts AC here in India. Though there is a metal cover protecting the terminals, this place is a bad choice. ZoneStar, if you are watching this video, please make sure you move this to another place in your next revision. Now let's install the power supply module to the right side base frame using M3 nylon screws and attach it to the frame using 3 M3 6mm screws. Make sure your input setting is set to either 110 volts or 220 volts depending on your country. Let's attach the filament feeder acrylic sheet to the frame. This is an optional part, so some of you may not get this. I couldn't find the instructions to assemble this part, so let's try to assemble it on our own. Now it's time to do all the wiring. ZoneStar has included this nice wiring diagram in the memory card. Let's attach the stepper motor cables to the controller board. The cables are of different length because the motors are located at different positions. The wiring diagram includes the sockets where you have to attach the stepper motor driver, the motor cables, and the end stop modules. Let's attach the smaller cable to the Y-axis motor since it is very near. Then the left side filament feeder motor to the E0 socket and the right side feeder motor to the E1 socket. Okay, let's do the power supply wiring. The AC input switch has colored wires. Yellow should be connected to the power supply ground. The phase line is colored red and the neutral is colored black. The 12V DC output is taken from the V- and V+ pins of the power supply and should be connected to the controller board's DC input screw terminals. We can connect the extruder temperature sensor just near the heat bed socket. The LCD controller cables can be attached to the controller board using the EXP1 and EXP2 connectors. Let's connect the hot end cooling fan and the print object cooling fan to the sockets labeled as fan on the controller board. The first socket is for the print object cooling fan and the second socket is for the hot end cooling fan. Fine. The wiring is complete. Now let's connect the PTA feed tube to allow the filament to reach the hot end from the feeder. It's time to tighten the jack screws of the coupling and wherever tightening is necessary. Let's wind the power supply wires with PE pipe envelope tube wire insulation. This should make the wirings look good. But the length of the insulation is not sufficient to wrap all the wires. Okay, we are done. Let's power it on for the first time. I personally don't want to print directly on the heat bed because the plate may get damaged if the nozzles are not calibrated properly. So I bought a glass plate, a high quality masking tape and some metal clips on Amazon. My first few prints were a failure. This is because every time when the first nozzle prints something, the second nozzle tore it away. This was caused by the improper alignment of the nozzle's height, so make sure you adjust the nozzles correctly. The next subsequent prints looks promising, but not good enough. Then I tried to tweak the setting in the cura slicer. I experimented with different temperatures, different density, changed speeds, and I could see the prints getting better. There is a torture test to benchmark the 3D printers. An open source 3D model called Benchy is available. Benchy was designed to see how the printer handles the complex printing operations like overhangs, curved surfaces, first layer print, holes, slopy surfaces, etc. I am printing it in two colors. I am using a configuration called Ooze Shield to avoid any leaking or oozing of the nozzles while printing from another extruder. This configuration will allow the hot end to print another layer around the model, which can later be removed using a cutter. The actual prints will be intact without much color overlap. I have printed the Benchy with 0.1mm and 0.2mm resolutions. The 0.1mm resolution looks better than the 0.2mm resolution. The quality of this print is not high and not bad as well. But the quality is much better in single color prints. The surface looks almost even. The holes are perfect. I hope I can improve the quality as I go on. You are looking at prints I made for my other projects. There are some intermittent protrusions in print. I couldn't find the reason for this. I will update once I find the reason. So here are my final thoughts. This is a bang for the buck. The assembly instructions were precise. The CNC milled mild steel build quality is great. It took just a few hours for me to assemble it, but I couldn't get a proper print for at least 3 days. The calibration was a little tricky. I personally don't prefer the controls on the LCD because you can't pause the print or stop the print just like that. Unlike MakerBot, every time you have to go through corresponding setting and then choose to pause or stop the prints. If you want to change the filament, you have to select the extruder first from another menu. I prefer the Repetier Host PC application and I use cura slicer. Repetier Host is a great software that can do real-time changes to the print without any hassle. All you need is a PC or laptop with you. Fine, I hope some of you found this video interesting. This video should help when we design our own 3D printer from scratch. I will see you next week with another interesting video. Thanks for watching this video. See you again.